Hey Star Wars fans, this is FLYGUY from FLYGUY.net, giving you an HD widescreen review of this, Jabba's Palace. We're having a bit of a reshuffle around here in the reviewing room, shall we call it, so we're giving you a look at this in a bit of a close-up. So here's the box, Jabba's Palace number 9516 is the set, and it's an epic update as far as Jabba is concerned and a few of the minifigures. The minifigures really are the steal of this package, but we get basically Jabba's throne, a little bit of his palace, and this huge kind of clock tower you can just see there. It's like a clock tower anyway. So it makes a really good diorama and kind of playset piece, and we'll give you a good high def close up on all the minifigures. But just to show you, there's Jabba, Salacious, Crumb, Bit Fortuna, Bomar Monk, Boushh, basically Princess Leia, Oola, Gamorrean guard, who's just fantastic, a Chewie we've had before, a slight change to Han, and basically Han and carbonite. So a real huge amount of minifigures on this one. Just to get a look at the back of the box, there are some play features. It wouldn't be a Lego unless there was some flick missiles, as you can see up at the top of Jabba's palace. A few other bits and pieces. You can peek your Gamorrean guard through the tower and rotate bits and pieces. You'll see Jabba has a bit of a hidden throne. You can move aspects of his throne out the way and display not only the rancor underneath, well, there's no rancor, but you know what I mean, the rancor plate, but he has some kind of hidden compartment underneath Jabba's throne. Not quite sure why, but there we go. What else have we got? Yep, you can flip Han out of his carbonite, a few other bits and pieces, some gun turrets, and there's the droid at the opening of Jabba's gate. And that's pretty much about it. You can lower and raise the gate, and that's your whack. Anyway, let's get a look at the set. Comes with two manuals, pretty standard stuff. Not quite as glossy as that skiff guard, or sorry, the skiff we reviewed a few days ago, but still nice to get that instruction manual all the less. There is a bit of a cartoon, I believe, in the back of one of these. Let me just show you quickly. There we go. And you get to see one of these things. We've seen to be a lot of these sets, including the Avengers ones as well. There's a little bit of an animated movie-like sequence storyboard there. But there we go. Right, let's do the minifigures first of all, because frankly they are the best things going in this one. Now let's dive straight in to have a look at one Gamorrean guard. He is fantastic. Look at the detail on this guy. Almost as good as the Hasbro one as far as I'm concerned. That is, if you can find one of the Hasbro ones. One axe that he comes with, one pretty standard piece. And there he is again, just to show you the details. So he's got fur on his legs, silver belt buckle, fur on his top. He's basically all one piece that comes apart like so. Plugs in, so very much like Chewie, but great detail in his snout and his shoulders. And on the back, again, just the paintwork on it's really well done. That's one epic looking Gamorrean guard. Who else have we got? Chewie, we've seen many times before, really the same Chewie. Really probably could do with a bit of an update, but there we go, he's still good old Chewie. Standard stuff, he's got his bandolier, he comes with these handcuffs here, and that's pretty much him. Again, one piece overall that he just slips on over the top. That's Chewie. Boushh is something a bit of a revelation. It's a really beautiful looking piece in terms of the paintwork. That helmet is just off the chart. Absolutely fantastic for Lego to do that in a scale. And there have been so many customs made over the years. I'm going to take the backpack off to show you the bits and pieces. You've got a double-sided Leia head, one where she's got a red lipstick on, and one where she's not looking too happy. She also has a hairpiece which comes in the set, which when you plug on, there we go, you can have Leia displaying with a helmet off, basically. If you look at that tiny little thermal detonator, it's a single coin-like piece of Lego, and you actually get two in the set, but great to get that thermal detonator piece. Beautiful print on the body and the legs there, fantastically done. All the detail of Boushh, and on the back, I should have taken that off. I'll show you just underneath the backpack. Whoops. Again, more detail on that minifigure, the back strap there. So beautifully done, a great minifigure, and again that helmet is just off the charts in terms of detail. Absolutely love it. Boushh the Bounty Hunter. And that's just a standard kind of pole with another part of Lego on the bottom is the staff. Okay, getting back into the set, once we take the lid of this thing off, I'll show you some other minifigures in here. Another great one is the fantastic looking Oola. Incredibly bright green. She's got a fishnet panty stocking thing on, whatever you want to call it. And all the headgear, very similar to the Twilight Jedi Aayla Secura. And again, all the detail on her printed back. You can just see underneath there's a double faced head. So she's got a panic face on and her happy face on. So there you go. One dancing girl, Oola. Great minifigure again, and love that headpiece. It's really well done. All the paintwork and the studs around there. Hockey, nearly done on the minifigures. One excellent update is Bib Fortuna. Look at that face. Really unique Lego piece on the top of the head here. This bobbly kind of all-in-one piece here. It's a very unusual part. You're not going to get anywhere else, so expect Bib to go for a few bucks. He doesn't have a reversible head. He's got a permanent, not too happy, teethy kind of look, but great print on his body. And he's got a little bit on his back, I believe. Let me just take that off to show you. Oh, no, he's got nothing. Nothing on the back print. So that's a Bib Fortuna. Now, one Bomar Monk we've seen before in an old set before is really just a single piece of coloured Lego hood inside this fishbowl-like piece with four ninja swords, which basically makes it a little bit of a con, this one. They could have done a bit of an update, but it still functions as a decent minifigure, so that's your whack in terms of that one. Han Solo, if we take a look at him, is the same as the Slave 1 Carbonite Han Solo we've seen before in that Slave 1 set. There's a review of that on the channel if you want to check it out. In the back, it also fits in Han Solo. Now, it says this is a new Han Solo. In actual fact, the only difference I can see is the facial sculpt. So, facial print. So, on one side, we get the same Han Solo torso with his open shirt and pants. But on the back, he's got two faces. He's got his I'm in hibernatic carbonite sleeping mode. Otherwise, that's it. There's really no difference to Han Solo, I think, apart from his slightly sullen look there in his face instead of his normal cocky kind of grin. That's the minifigure for Han Solo. Leaving pretty much at the, well, just before we do the very final piece, I'll show you one other tiny little minifigure is one Salacious Crumb, who is a very cool part for Lego, because really the only Lego part he's got is his butt. Everything else is brand new, molded, highly detailed. We'd never get this from Lego from years ago. Just really, really cool, absolutely excellent. This could sit on top of a Hasbro figure, it's so good. It just looks the part. Really, really cool, Salacious Crumb. But this is the big guy. This is the guy in the set that's causing a lot of the fuss, and people wanted to see this huge Jabba update. We've seen some Jabbas in the past, and he was nothing to write home about. He was just basically a big blob of painted, well, not even painted plastic. This one, we get some great looking effects and detail here. The eyes look like Jabba, huge, shiny, kind of amber coloured eyes. The nostrils, the paint on the belly, and of course, we get the figure to display and rotate as well. That just plugs in via one piece underneath, and that's what you get. That's it. He's got movable arms as well, which is rather cool. And that's Jabba. He's an excellent looking piece and really the kind of part you're going to pay the most for in this set. So there we go. That's all the minifigures. Let me take you through the set. If you want to hang around, you can see the rest of the set and some of the features on it. So lots of different pieces to this playset. Let me zoom in there a little bit and we'll show you a little more. Lots of different pieces on this. As you'll see, the throne actually comes out and is a standard kind of piece there. That's where Jabba sits. Nice detail for the kind of pieces that are on his throne. Actually, those little studs work really well, but that's it. It sits in this kind of compartment, and you'll see in there are some bits and pieces stored away inside. Let me just show you a little bit closer. You can see it there. There's basically a fireplace, which is at the back of Jabba's palace, and it pops in it, and that pushes the throne forward. Not quite sure what it's doing there. It looks fine there, but that's obviously the piece to... If I put the throne back in, there we go. And if I'm setting the throne there, then pushing that allows that to the throne to move forward. So there's nothing to basically show anything for the Rancor underneath, but we do have a compartment when I pull here. This is space underneath. So one day, hopefully soon, maybe we'll make a Rancor's cave, and we can sit this piece on top of it. That would just be rather cool. Fingers crossed, Lego, they're going to do that. But really, there's not a great deal other else going on in this set. We've got a little hookah set here, which is what Jabba puffs away on in the movie. And let me just quickly show you inside that. There's a little tiny little, you could almost call it a minifigure. It's a little frog. If you can see this, let me see if I can close that for you. For those interested, it's incredibly small. But there we go. A little tiny Lego frog is what's put inside Jabba's little hookah set there as he puffs away and eats his frogs. Other bits and pieces on the set, you can obviously have Han Solo's carbonite rotate. And whoops, let me just show you that again. So you can place Han Solo there into this base as he clips on, and you can actually have him positioned there, and that can rotate around to show Han. There's a tiny little control panel here as well. But that's pretty much in terms of the features. The overall, well, one other feature just at the front of the set here is this revolving door, or the moving door that she goes up. And as you'll see, if you pull this, that set comes up. And this part, we'll just zoom in a little bit to show you that, is the element where 3PO and R2, at the beginning of the movie, you can just push a small part. There we go. And out comes the droid, which basically interrogates them at the beginning of the movie. Let me just give you a zoom up on that. It's a very small one by one, one circular piece. And you have to get two of them in the pack. But a very simple piece. You just press the lever in the back. You can see it at the back of that doorway. And that allows that to pop out there. So you pop that back in. And then you can continue to bring your shutter up for your door. These move up and down, and that's about all they do, but still cool nonetheless. And there's that fireplace piece we mentioned earlier on. You pull that out, doesn't really do a great deal. You can dismantle this tower here, it's held in by a couple of studs. There we go. So you can take this apart and move that around if you wanted to, and you get your standard different pieces. But that's pretty much the interior of Jabba's palace itself. You're really buying this for the minifigures, as I said. It's the coolest part of the set. But otherwise, very simple build. Really not too hard, doesn't take long at all. And pretty good fun. That's just another close-up of that piece there, I'll just show you. And again, just all the bits and pieces on this tower. Some micro binoculars and a blaster and a few other bits of storage. That's really all you're getting inside there. And then on top of that, Jabba's, the rooftop for Jabba's palace is basically a simple, kind of looks like a spaceship there. Has this flick missile here, and if we hold that, press that there you go, one flick missile. Pretty uneventful stuff, really. But that's it, and that just slots on the top of the palace there, and that's you. That's Jabba's palace. Let us know what you think. We love this in terms of the minifigures. This guy is just amazing. As is Boushh and some of the other people in the minifigures here. So yeah, let us know if you want to get it or not. I got this from the excellent shopforme.com.au. They are the cheapest place in Australia for Lego. They knocked off a whole $50 off the recommended retail price. And I haven't seen anywhere that's offered a discount of that size. So they're pretty epic, and thank you very much to them for getting this set early. I believe a lot of you guys in the US, if you're watching this, still haven't had these sets in stores, which is a bit of a shame, but I'm no doubt you'll get them soon enough. So, Lego Jabba's Palace is the bomb. Let us know what you think again, comments below or on facebook.com/flyguy.net, and lots more Lego reviews coming up soon. Cheers.